Words of Sri Aurobindo. Earth Consciousness. The Earth Consciousness does not want to change, so it rejects what comes down to it from above. It has always done so. It is only if those who have taken this yoga open themselves and are willing to change their lower nature that this unwillingness can disappear. What stands in the way, of course, is always the vital ego, with its ignorance and the pride of its ignorance, and the physical consciousness with its inertia, which resents and resists any call to change, and its indolence, which does not like to take the trouble. It finds it more comfortable to go on its own way, repeating always the same old movements, and at best expecting everything to be done for it in some way at some time. The first thing is to have the right inner attitude. You have that. The rest is the will to transform oneself and the vigilance to perceive and reject all that belongs to the ego and the tamasic persistence of the lower nature. Finally, to keep always oneself open to the mother in every part of the being so that the process of transformation may find no hindrance. There is another cause of the general inability to change which at present afflicts the sadhak. It is because the sadhana, as a general fact, has now and for a long time past come down to the inconscient. The pressure, the call, is to change in that part of the nature which depends directly on the inconscient, the fixed habits, the automatic movements, the mechanical repetitions of the nature, the involuntary reactions to life, all that seems to belong to the fixed character of a man. This has to be done if there is to be any chance of a total spiritual change. The force, generally and not individually, is working to make that possible. Its pressure is for that. For on the other levels, the change has already been made possible, not, mind you, assured to everybody. But to open the inconscient to light is a Herculean task. Change on the other levels is much easier. As yet, this work has only begun, and it is not surprising that there seems to be no change in things or people. It will come in time, but not in a hurry. As for experiences, they are all right, but the trouble is that they do not seem to change the nature. They only enrich the consciousness. Even the realization on the mind level of the Brahman seems to leave the nature almost where it was, except for a few. That is why we insist on the psychic transformation as the first necessity. For that does change the nature, and its chief instrument is bhakti, surrender.